Good evening. Now our next topic is static member functions in C++. In our last lecture, we have seen the static data members in C++ and the characteristics of static data members. Like static member variables or static data members, we can also have static member functions in C++. A member function that is declared with static keyword is called as static member function. It has two important properties that you have to write into the exam. The first important property is a static function can have access to only static members. It means that a static member function can have access to static variables or static functions only, which was declared inside the same class. A static member function, second property is a static member function can be called using the class name instead of its objects. It means you cannot call a static member function using the object and the dot operator. We have to call a static member function with the help of class name and scope restriction operator. So this is the syntax. This line is the syntax for calling the static member function. Class name, scope restriction operator and the function name. So this way we call static member function. So we have to remember two important properties of static member function. Okay. So we'll see a program which illustrates the use of the static member function and how this static member function can access the static variables. This is the program which is just modified version of our previous program that we have seen for static data members. Again, the class name is test, which has two variables. One is code and another is count variable, which is declared as static here. Okay, and both these are in private area of the class. In public area, we have three functions. One is set code, another is set show code, and last one is show count function. If you see in this definition of show code and set code, they are not declared with the keyword static. It means these functions are not static member function. But the third function is declared with the keyword static. So it means there is only one static member function, that is nothing but show count into this class. Now we'll see the coding of each and every function. In set code function, we are just assigning the code to the objects. Code equal to plus plus count. In show code function, we are just displaying the value of the code or value of the object. Okay. In show count function, we are going to display the count value. Now, if you see, count is nothing but a static member, right? And a show count function is a static member function, which can call only, or we can only access static members, maybe a variable or it may be a function. So it cannot access other variables. So here, if you see, count was declared static, and this function is now accessing static variables. Okay, here we are displaying the value of the count, and at last we are closing the class with the help of semicolon. As we have seen in our previous program, all the static variables must be defined outside the class. Similarly, here also in this program, the static variable count is defined outside the class here in the line with the help of class name and scope restriction operator. So data type, class name, scope restriction operator and the static variable name, that is count, give the semicolon at last. Okay. In the main program, we will create two objects, say t1 and t2 here, and we accessed the function set code through t1, that is t1.setcode and t2.setcode, right? And there is a call to the static function, that is show count. See how that function has been called here. Static functions can only be accessed or called using the class name and scope restriction operator. We cannot call any static function with the help of object and dot operator. We have to call all the static functions using the class name, scope restriction operator and the function name. Correct? So, can you tell me what would be the output of show count function here? the output till this line would be 2, because whenever you created the object t1 and t2, when you created the first object, count value automatically becomes 0, because it gets assigned automatically to 0, as we have learned into the previous lecture. Then when we call t1.setCode, count value gets incremented and assigned to the object. That is, after this line, setCode for t1 is 1 and count is also 1. After this line, t2 has code 2 and count variable value is also 2. So if I try to display that showCount function to display the count value, it displays value 2 at this line. Okay. Now we also created one more variable t3, and again we call the function setCode, where the t3 code becomes 3 and count becomes 3. If I try to display it with the help of the static function, it will display the count value as 3. Then there are three different calls goes to the function showCode: t1.showCode, t2.showCode and t3.showCode. The output of this line are nothing but, for in t1 there was 1, in t2 there was 2, in t3 there was code 3. So it will display the output as 1, 2 and 3 in the objects t1, t2 and t3 respectively. So this is the output of the previous program. In between call, we called the showCode function, showCount function, there the count was 2. Later on again we called the showCount function, that time the call was, count was 3. At last we displayed the values of the objects. It displays in object number 1 the value 1, in object number 2 the value 2, and in object number 3 the value 3. In the entire program, your main focus should be on this definition of the static function and which variable that function can access, right? As mentioned into the properties of the static member function, it can only access the static members, maybe a variable or maybe a function. So this is a access to the code variable. Okay, so this ends your lecture on static functions in C++. Thank you.